Hi everyone, Jewel here for J7409 Tropical Update. I have some very important stuff in this one. I will not have another update until probably late this evening, but this is very, very important. Looking like Dorian is going to become a Cat 4 hurricane. Okay, here's a tracking map right here. I'm going to show you a lot of things, so let's just get to it. Now, everybody needs to click Show More and read what I have down there under these tropical updates. Now, I always put the forecast position and max winds in it. This is from the very latest update. You see, the winds get up to 130 miles per hour. That is a Category 4, folks. What does a Category 4 do? Here we go. Catastrophic damage will occur. Well-built frame homes. It doesn't matter how good of a house you have. Well-built frame homes can sustain severe damage with loss of most of the roof structure and or some exterior walls. Now, most trees will be snapped and uprooted, power poles down, fallen trees, and power poles are going to isolate the residential areas, okay? Power outages will last, this is important, weeks to possibly months. Power outages will last weeks to possibly months. Most of the area will be uninhabitable for weeks or months. You see it right there, Category 4. I'm not saying this. I'm not showing you this to scare you. I'm making you aware of when this thing hits, wherever it comes in, this is what you can expect as of now. Let's hope and pray it changes, but this is what it's looking like as of now, wherever it comes inland. Not once it gets inland, wherever it comes inland. Now, back to what I pounce on you all the time about knowing your coordinates. It is so important to know. Mine is 37.57 north, 77.5 west. Now, when you look at these wind speeds, and it gives the location, I'm going to show, some of you may know this, but I bet a whole bunch of you don't do this. I'm going to show you what to do, okay? All right, the last in 96 hours when it's 130 mile per hour, when it's getting closer to the coast, it's 27.5 north, 79.8 west. Now, in the day of modern technology, all you have to do is put in the coordinates, and it pops right up. It shows you where it's at, and then you have the National Hurricane Center's outlook. So, at 130 mile per hour, a Cat 4, okay? With those coordinates, 27.5 north, 79.8 west. Here it is still in the Atlantic Ocean over here, but this is going to give you a better view of what to look for. I'd say anywhere from Sebastian all the way down here. It's looking like it's probably going to be in this area, right in here between Palm City and Vero Beach, Fort Pierce, St. Lucie. You guys bless your hearts all the way around. But this is where these Category 4 winds could come in. As of now, like I say, it may change. Now, once it gets inland and it gets down to a Cat 1, it's at 28.1 north, 81.5 west. And where would that be? Right here. Here you go. This is in Polk County, Florida. Okay? You guys know if you live anywhere around here, Orlando's up to the north. We got Winter Haven, Avon Park, Sebring down to the south. Not really that far, but the National Hurricane Center is saying it should be to a Category 1 at this time, but personally, I don't know if I would trust that, but let's hope that's what happens. So I wanted to show you this and let you understand. You guys can, if you just click show more on my videos, I always have this information available for you to track. Now, I keep harping a lot about the jet stream, the low pressure, the high pressure. The high pressure is going to be up here. A low pressure is going to be building down in here. This is going to draw this down some. The high pressure is pushing downward. This low pressure is pulling it to it. This low pressure and high pressure is making this corridor for the path. This one's pushing it down. This one's pulling it down. This is what's making this path come up in here. So I wanted to make sure you knew about that. Looks like it will take a little more of a northerly turn at this time. As you can see, looking like it's going to come in a little north up here. Okay. Still in the middle, but a little north. And right where I showed you, that's what the National Hurricane Center is forecasting at this time. But anybody from the Outer Banks all the way down to the Keys, you need to prepare. So far as the Outer Banks themselves, right up in this area in North Carolina, it's looking like by Sunday, we could be getting some rain bands from Doria. Now, I'm not saying we're having a hurricane at that time or a tropical storm. I'm just saying that's when we could start to see some rain bands from Hurricane Dorian. Now, for everybody up in South Carolina and Georgia in these areas, you need to prepare. We all need to prepare, okay? I've just showed you that. But this storm could be coming up and going into Georgia very well in parts of South Carolina and North Carolina. This is what the governor of the state of Georgia, it's not a state of emergency yet, but he is telling everybody to prepare. And even our local weather people of where I am all the way up here, now they have started to say, we got to watch this thing a little bit better because we're not quite sure where it's going to go. Folks, I don't know if you realize this or not, but it has been 14 years ago today that Hurricane Katrina struck Louisiana. How about that? Anyway, here's some things you need to know. I'm sure these things are going to build as by Saturday it'll be totally different. Tomorrow it'll be different, okay? But on this track, Dorian should move over the Atlantic well east of the southeastern and central Bahamas today and tomorrow, and approach the northwestern Bahamas Saturday or move nearer over the portions of the northwest Bahamas Sunday. And by the way, Dorian does have an eye now, working on a second eye wall. Don't know how that's going to turn out yet, though. Just thought I'd throw it in there for you, okay? And the winds, the tropical storm force winds now, you can tell this little teeny storm that was so many days ago, it is growing in size at this point. Now they extend up to 90 miles. At one point, it was like 25 miles. So the hurricane force winds, they extend 15 miles from the center. The tropical storm force winds extend 90 miles from the center. Hazard right now, this is the rain. The central Bahamas, 1 to 2 inches, isolated 4. Northwestern Bahamas, 3 to 6 inches, isolated 8. Coastal sections of the southeast United States, 4 to 8 inches with an isolated 12. That's going to cause flash flooding. That's going to cause a lot of problems for a lot of people in a lot of places. Be aware of that. This rainfall may cause life-threatening flash floods. So, you know that scenario. You see the water standing on the road or rushing on the road. Don't drive through it. Turn around. Don't drive. Of course, we're going to have swells around the U.S. and the British Virgin Islands and Puerto Rico. Yours should gradually diminish. Now, swells are likely to begin affecting the east-facing shores of the Bahamas and the southeastern United States coast during the next few days. These swells are likely to cause life-threatening surf and rip current conditions. And if you are a surfer at a Category 4 hurricane coming in, please do not go out in it. Please don't. I'm going to wrap this update up for now. I've showed you some important things. Looking like a Category 4 at landfall. Once it hits land, it should start to diminish. But it's too far out now to tell how long it's going to maintain these hurricane strength winds. It's going over land, so that should knock it down some. But tropical storm, that's another thing. I've had just as much damage from rain in a tropical storm than I have a hurricane. Tropical storm conditions are going to remain even when it gets up into Georgia. Still could be a hurricane, not saying it's not going to be. And as it moves all the way up through the Carolinas, out through the Outer Banks, that's a possibility. And you can see at this time, this cone has moved greatly. So we've got to keep our eyes on it. But I just wanted to show you these things, make you be aware, and please, please take action now. If you live by yourself, make sure you get in contact with your friends, have a plan, stay in contact with people. If you got a family, make sure you got all your important papers, everything together, and make sure you stay in contact with people. For goodness sakes, don't forget to check on your neighbors, the handicapped, the elderly. Make sure they're safe if you have someone like that living around you. And your pets, please, please, please make sure they have a safe place to be during this, especially along the coastline of Florida, if this comes in as a Category 4 hurricane. Everybody, please be safe. I'll have more late this evening. It might even be early nighttime hours for me. I won't put anything more up today. But until then, I want to give it some time to see what it does here. But Georgia, South Carolina, the Carolinas, we're still not out of the woods. I don't think when it gets to us, it'll be a hurricane, but it could be a tropical storm. Might not be anything at this point, but like I said, on the Outer Banks by Sunday, we should start feeling some rain bands from Hurricane Dorian. Everybody else, make sure you are prepared big time, and stay safe. I love you guys a lot. Thanks for everything you do for me. Peace, love, and kindness to all. Please share this video with everybody you know to help me to keep people safe. Take care. Thanks for watching.